What's up guys, Mark from Wandering Souls, back with a new video. Been to a festival, so let's give it here my thoughts. This is a festival, my perspective on the festival, Fortarock this year. Well, what can I say, people? It was a bit, doubt between a lot of Dutch people for going or not. There were not a lot of tickets sold. I heard from a lot of people, and there could be some issues because of that. The festival decided to give, if you buy a ticket, you get you can take one person for free with you into the festival. It's a really nice action, of course, but it also means there were not sold a lot of tickets. I heard there were sold approximately 2,500 tickets sold, so that means 5,000 people there, maybe more, but I think overall it was pretty crowded there. I wasn't expected that because there were not a lot of tickets sold in forehand. Maybe there were some people who thought, let's go anyway, because one thing was for sure, the weather was outstanding. Really nice weather there, nice sunny weather, here and there some shadow spots, really nice rearranged terrain. It was a bit changed compared to last year. I like the how it was set up right this year. Three stages, one big stage, a big tent stage, and a smaller stage which also with a roof above it. It was really interesting. Was a bee garden, was a lot of food, course, different kind of, a lot of bars overall over the festival, a lot of stuff, a lot of sitting places where you can sit down. It's really pretty good arranged. Of course the lineup was pretty okay too. There were a lot of struggles to get a big name for this festival. There were trying to get Slayer, but they couldn't get Slayer for headliner, but because Slayer is stopping with touring and stuff. So, and there were a lot of bands not on tour yet, but probably next month or so. Overall, there were a pretty decent stack of bands, like Behemoth, Bloodbath was there, Children of Bodom. There were 2 day festivals. They had Amonamar of Hammerfall, Catatonia, Symphony X. They are pretty big names, but not as high up as Slayer, for example. But I really enjoyed my time. I went 1 day instead of two. Why? Because I liked the bands on day one better than the second day. That can happen, I think. But I went only 1 day with my pal and met some other people as well there on the festival. I enjoyed my time, find a nice weather with the festival, so that's really good. There was a metal market as well, so I bought also some stuff which I'm gonna show you later in this video. First of all, I'm gonna talk about the bands a bit. The first band I saw was in the 10th stage, and that was Godmother. A band I never heard of. They are from Sweden. Play a bit of mishmash of genres, D-beat, cross-punk. There was some grindcore in it, some black metal elements. Really strange combination. But if you think like bands like Converse, Diligent Escape Plan, with that style changes and tempo variations in there, then you can probably get an idea how the band sounds. Overall it was a pretty nice set. I really enjoyed it. Busy frontman interacting with the public, going into the stage, climbing onto the pillars of the tent itself, going in a mosh pit, There was even some crowd surfing from him. The bass player was also really active, headbanging and stuff, screaming along with the vocalist. The drummer was a pure beast, blasting through the set, a really nice drummer. Guitar player had some nice solos here and there as well, but was the person that was not most in front, I think. The bass player and the singer are the most active persons on the stage, in my opinion. But yeah, really did a good job, I think. Didn't know the band, but I liked what I saw, so yeah. Thumbs up for you guys. Godmother, really nice band. Then over to the main stage, I saw Obliviscaris, probably butchered that name, but band I never saw live. Never have dived into that band deeply. I know some stuff from them, I saw some videos and stuff like that, but yeah, really enjoyed the band. Professional musicians, they know the instruments really well, especially the bass player was a really amazing dude, man. He killed it with his amazing bass work. Good stuff. Really nice guitar solos here and there from the bald-headed guitar player. Really nice and well done. And of course the clean singer with his violin. Yeah, really, really nice front man. I would have expected that the harsh vocalist would take more part to the front, but he didn't for some reason. The announcements of the songs and stuff like that were more done by the man, the singer with the clean vocal. Overall, pretty good set, although I think the sound here and there could be better because it was a lot of focused on bass, double kick drum, a lot of triggers. The harsh vocals were more in front. Yeah, and overall I think it all could be more into one piece of music. But overall every instrument, you can hear every instrument, but that's really not a problem. Overall, it's an outside stage, so the sound has to be good, otherwise it flows away to other places and you only hear a certain instrument. So yeah, not that it was bad, but yeah, it could be better. But I really enjoyed the show, played very well, although I was not super familiar with the material, but yeah, enjoyed my time with that band. Next up was Mono Lord in the 10th stage. I didn't really have seen them perform. I was outside the stage sitting down on a bench. But I can hear them clearly because their doom metal sound was so fucking heavy in the mix. You can clearly hear it outside the stage, pummeling. Really heavy guitars, heavy bass. Yeah, really cool doom metal, but yeah, I was gladly not to see them in the tent because I really need some things in my ear for that. Although I have used them during the day because I don't want to ruin my ears. But yeah, anyways, yeah, it was really heavy sound, heavy guitars, heavy doom. Pretty decent stuff, I think, although I could have seen them. Would have seen them inside, but I was really not feeling the need to go into the 10th stage. It just was chilling a bit. Eat drinks and stuff like that. Really chilling down, talking a bit to some people, and yeah. Yeah, really good stuff, I think. Next band on the main stage was Atreyu, the metalcore band. I don't have a lot of stuff with them. I don't really interested in what they do. It's not really my thing, so to speak. They play pretty well, so I heard in the back because I was getting some drinks and stuff. But yeah, it just wasn't really my thing. But they probably didn't do anything bad because crowd was enjoying their performance, so probably they did something good. Next up, a band I was really wanting to see that was Enslaved. Was a long way back I saw them. I think it was also Fourth of Rock, if I'm not mistaken. Or was it Fields of Rock? I don't know, I think Fields of Rock. I can't remember, but it was a long time ago I have seen them and I was really enjoying their performance. Mixed of newer stuff with some really old stuff. Nice sound, full in the picture, full sound. Really nice performance from the band itself. I was really enjoying myself and the crowd as well. So it was really amazing performance. I really enjoyed Enslaved, and yeah, definitely is a band that I want to see live more times. Not that I'm gonna visit every concert, but I don't mind to see them more often. I really enjoy that band. So yeah, really great band, Enslaved. Then back to the main stage. There we saw a bit of Mirker. Probably butchered that again, but Amelie Brun, her band. Mixed the folky with black metal. Was getting slowly on tempo there. It was started off with some slower songs and clean vocals alone, and later on the black metal eventually came in. But in my opinion, they should try that a bit earlier. Or then I was more interested to see them, I think. But yeah, overall they performed good. Really nice things to add to the stage, some tree and some other things to set up the mood. Although I think this is something it could be better in the 10th stage. The honor for other girls to play on the main stage, but I think she would have fit better in the 10th stage. There was more atmosphere there than on the main stage for such dark stuff. There's also for all black metal bands, I think in the open air it's cool, but I think there are for small venues and tents, and that's better for the atmosphere on a black metal show in my opinion. But overall, pretty decent performance, although I've not seen the whole gig. But yeah, next up, I could choose Uncle Acid and Luster. Luster, I chose for Luster in the small podium. Band I'm familiar with, I've seen them before, a black metal band from Utrecht. Really cool black metal, high squishy vocals, atmospheric sounding black metal. Here and there some cleans, but overall really really good musicians. I also like their podium costumes with the white masks, really enjoyable to watch. Overall, really good performance, although the sound was a loud wall of sound, so I was glad to have my earplugs with me. So I enjoyed the gig a lot. The only thing that could better in the sound thing wise is the vocals a bit louder in the mix, or just turn the other things a bit down. That's also an option, but really good performance. Really enjoyed it, and great stuff. Yeah, really enjoyed the band. If you're not familiar with Luster, go check him out. You probably will be amazed. Even can dance to it if you want to. Don't think they're a disco band. No, they're not, but really great stuff. Then back to the main stage, Amorphis, a band I saw live more often than a lot of bands on this festival. I enjoyed the performance, but I really got the idea they played it a bit safe, in my opinion. Going to the easy songs just for the festival people. why not making a choice to play another song than the hit singles, for so to speak? Of course, they want to play the bigger song, the well-known songs, but yeah, more diversity would be really cool instead of playing every single every time. I know it's you have more less time to perform here, but yeah, take a chance, guys. Amaze people that have seen you more times. Right now, you get all the big House of Sleep and what the fuck is called? Or the bigger, cleaner songs like Blood Brother and stuff like that. Great songs in my opinion, but yeah, make it more diverse. I really would enjoy then the gig more. Although I really like they have played Black Winter Day, which is one of my favorite songs from the past. I'm really glad that they at least played that song, but yeah. Overall, pretty good performance, but I was not really surprised with their set list, so to speak. Cult of Luna, I heard only from the 10 stage. Again, the same thing as with Monolord. Big wall of sound. So I was just lying down outside the tent in the grass, enjoying some sun and some drinks, and getting more energy for the bands that came after that. But yeah, heavy wall of sound, post-metal band. I think they're from Sweden, if I'm not mistaken. But anyways, great stuff. Yeah, I was not really in the mood to get to go into that tent again to see them perform. But yeah, overall, I enjoyed it on the background and even a little chat with my friends. Yeah, overall, really enjoyable. Next up, back to the main stage again. Children of Bodom played, of course, some newer songs, but I really like they have played some old shit. Yeah, Hatecrew Death Roll, Every Time I Die. Dead Night Warrior, that kind of songs. Really enjoyed that they played some stuff from the earlier albums as well. But also is a bit of part of course, that the latest album is going back more into the old sound. So that has probably something to do with it. But yeah, overall, really cool performance. The first, the crowd went nuts. Big pit for the podium. Yeah, really good performance. Yeah, enjoyed it. So yeah, really nice to see them live again. It was probably the Dynamo Festival in 2004. I saw them last time live. So it has been 15 years. So yeah, really nice revisit. Then the band actually came for a bit on the festival. There was Bloodbath in the 10th stage. Yeah. What can I say, guys? Fucking amazing performance. Great show. Band members looking sick as always with the blood and stuff. And really great songs I performed live. Although I missed a few songs, but it's probably during the length of the show that they haven't played that. But overall, the last band in the 10th stage, they played an hour, I think. Yeah, they played an hour. Really great performance. A lot of people have something against Chris Holmes. I don't know. I think he did a pretty good job, actually. So, although I would have performed Michael Akerfeld, I'm really honest, but I really enjoyed his performance. Pretty good job, well done. Really enjoyed the gig overall. Yeah, the crowd was going nuts as well. Really great. Yeah, performance. Can't say nothing more, man. It really rules. Good sound, good, great light show. Yeah, awesome. Last band, main act, Behemoth. didn't watch the whole show because I want to get a train as well, because we were there by public transportation. But overall, I seen Behemoth not live not so long ago, and they did actually a bit the same as then. So I knew you get quality there, good stage performance, really nice light show, all nice decorated, full on set. Yeah, they played pretty long, I think. More than 1 hour, 1 hour and a quarter or something. But yeah, they really did a great job. Although I think it's not a band to go wild on live, some sort of reason, because they also play a lot of slower songs. If they would have played some older, faster songs, you get more wild. But for now, I think the performance was not really too much on board of whatever. Not that I'm really mosher, a lot more a headbanger than a mosher, I have to say. But yeah, I really enjoyed the gig. But yeah, we also need to get a train, so we left a bit early to get the train, so we didn't saw the whole performance. But what we saw was really good. Overall, I really enjoyed the festival. I'm wondering what they're gonna do next year, because this year they really needed to have it from the beers they sold, the drinks they sold, the food they have sold. Well, see what happens next year. For now, I think for the organization it was a bit of disappointment that they have give away a free ticket for every customer that comes, second customer, I have to say. Yeah, it's a bit of disappointment for them, I think, because they put a lot of effort to organize the festival in it every year. There were some years they didn't organize it for some of the same reasons, because the lack of headliners. But yeah, we have to think about that, I think. Is it possible, because all bands like Slayer and stuff gonna stop eventually, and there have to be some new bands coming up and rise up. But I think you get more bands that not as high up as bands like Slayer, but a little bit beneath it, and then more you have to choose more headliners. But they're not so famous as a Slayer or Metallica or Rammstein or whatever. You can get that name every time. It stops somewhere, and you know, it's early in the season as well. It's June, you guys. Most festivals are in July, August, that period. End of June. This is the beginning of June, and it's pretty early. A festival you could consider to do it later, but then you get the problems that there are other festivals as well. That's a bit hard decision. What are you gonna do? Keep it the same day and risking not to get a real big headliner that are not on tour, because you can get a big headliner, but you have to pay it before to fly into the Netherlands, and that is more money than they already are on tour. So it's a really big decision every time again. But yeah, who knows what happened next year. I don't know for sure if I'm going next year, but we'll see. Maybe not. Depends on what bands, of course, they are playing. Etc. But yeah, overall, it was a really nice day. The weather was also a really big help for getting more people on the ground. I think that helps a lot, that there were more people coming to the festival as well. If the weather was bad, or a lot of rain and stuff, I've wondered if they could manage it to hold it and not get a big financial loss. But there's probably some loss now, but not as big if there was bad weather or whatever. But yeah, overall, like I said, guys, pretty nice festival. Next festival I will be attending to, of course, is Stonehenge Festival in Steenwijk. As every year I do that. But yeah, and so a few concerts in between and after that and stuff like that. But not really a lot of festivals I'm attending this year. Maybe one more, but we'll see. It depends on the finances and stuff like that. Overall, I really enjoyed it. What was I gonna say? It doesn't matter anyways. Really enjoyed it. I didn't film a lot of stuff, actually. I took some pictures, of course, but that will be posted on the website and Facebook. Sorry, but I also wanted to join my Jamie lapel. I didn't want to continuously filming stuff if my pal was next to him. This is what also want to conversate sometimes, and maybe you're gonna film on Stonehenge again, I don't know, we'll see what happens. But for now I really enjoyed it. Like I said, I was also visiting the metal market on the Forta Rock Festival, so I did. So I'm just gonna show you what I've bought before I do that. Name of my beer. Yes, it's a really dark beer. German beer. I got this from my dad-in-law. It tasted pretty sweet, I have to say. This is Stutterbeker with Hansa Porter. Really, really nice German beer. Anyways, to the stuff I bought. Bought 3 CDs and 1 t-shirt. Let's start with the CD first. Incinerator with Stench of Distress. And this is some Dutch old school death metal, released by Raw Skull Records. And if you're into old school death metal, you definitely will enjoy this. Really cool stuff. Definitely worth checking out, guys. Good stuff. Next up, the first album by Mournful Congregation. I'm spinning that stuff a lot lately and just found that first album I was looking for. So I really was stoked to see that. This is Tears from a Grieving Heart. Awesome. Funeral Doom from Australia, if you're not familiar with this band. Really great stuff, and I'm really glad to have this in my collection. Almost complete now. I'm just missing one full length, I think. Some EPs and stuff, but I really want to have the full length for sure. And also picked up the last Bloodbath. Still needed the physical copy of that, so yeah. I think the Arrow of Satan is drawn. Saw this for a nice price. I thought, snag it. I need that. So yeah, really glad to add this to my Bloodbath collection. Great stuff. And also bought a shirt, like I said. Not a band that was playing on the festival. I've looked at the festival merch for the festival itself and the band merch that were playing there. It was on the same side of the festival, not on the metal market but on the other side. Didn't really like the design of any shirt that was hanging there, so I just went to the metal market, went through from a lot of shirts and just found this one. One of my favorite bands as well, so I thought, yeah, maybe you're gonna grab this one. Bought me a shirt of my Dying Bride, Turn Loose the Swans, classic album. I thought, let's buy a shirt from that. And the back print is like the back cover with the song titles. Really cool. So I'm really glad to own a shirt of my Dying Bride now. But yeah, really enjoyed the day, like I said. Metal Market was fun too. Although I saw just like last year, 4 times the same seller in the CD section. Still find it a bit awkward, But anyways, there are some other stands as well, so yeah. I think I only bought this one at that stand, the other two at a more smaller stand, and that was only one stand there. Anyways, yeah, really cool stuff. We were a lot selling a lot of shirts, patches, CDs, vinyl. I would have grabbed some vinyl, but when I rented their locker, I just found out that was only this big. And I thought, no, that's not gonna fit a vinyl, so just keep it two CDs. Yeah, I thought about a bit strange because I asked for a big locker, and yeah, what did I get? There were not a lot of big lockers, only a lot small ones, so yeah, shit happens. Anyways, yeah, that's it guys. Hope you enjoyed this video. Sorry, no video live footage, but yeah, I've seen there is a lot of live footage of this festival on YouTube, so Ticket Inforta Rock 2019, you probably get a lot of live stuff, but because there were a lot of people filming as well, other people. But anyway, thank you for watching, liking and supporting, guys. Really appreciate it, and hope to see you with my next video. Thank you, take care, have a nice day.